Hello, good evening, and welcome. Every now and then, a superstar comes along. Hollywood, Elstree, Slough. And one of those superstars is
Epsom.
Formerly Terry Simpson, but now better known, rather like Madonna, with one name, Simmons. Simmons has been the star of so many films. He does his own stunts, he does his own scripts. In fact, he does everything his way. And I'm pleased tonight that we're going to devote the whole programme to Simmons. So please welcome Simmons! Well, Simmons, it's lovely to see you.
Yeah, and you.
We met some 3 or 4 years ago when you were starring in one of your famous films. In
fact, that's right.
This series has gone on more than the carry-ons.
Hasn't it just?
Yes, indeed. Now, the reason you're here today is to, well, really, to plug your new autobiography.
Money, that's what I mean.
Well, Simmons, My Life. An unusual photograph on the front. Would you like to tell us about that particular occasion?
My finger was poorly. I had to air it.
Right, I think we'll move on from there. Let's talk about some of the films you've starred in. You've always been a great campaigner against hooliganism and the like. And I remember the film very clearly when you returned to your roots as Batman. And
hang on, I'm getting a prompt.
and indeed, you were very, very caring about bus drivers and bus passengers. Would you like to? Oh, in fact, we've got a shot first, just a short video to show some of you in action.
Simmons device, instant punter alert.
Hello, sweetie. Oh, darling, no. Bless. The hooligans are on board now, are they? They've beaten you up, Simmons. Oh, bless, darling. Take care. All right, well, we'll see what we can do. I'll just talk to control.
Yeah, Graham, it looks like he's going to do it.
OK, sweetie, go ahead. Take care.
And so our hero releases the instant knockout gas, which has laid low the antisocial behaviour of Richmondville. Once
you actually gassed all the people on the bus.
Oh, I remember that. Yes, that was quite a laugh, wasn't it?
It was.
Quite fun.
You do realise that some of them had long-term effects.
Yeah, and me. Look.
Yeah. That's true. How long did you actually drive buses for?
God, now that's a question, isn't it?
It is a question.
A long time.
A long time.
Mr. Whiteway, yes.
Yes. What, and then, of course, your previous incarnation as Batman, and you were certainly one of those who...
That's a
great who really put a lot into that role.
Carnation.
Yeah. And I remember you running down the road and a coach overtaking you. You were quite out of breath.
Yes. Well, you would be, wouldn't you, at my age?
Yeah. How old are you, actually?
Getting on a bit.
Okay. That's, you're not prepared to reveal that, obviously.
No, because you wouldn't believe me.
But some of the other films you starred in, I remember particularly the scene when you were at a lake and you were controlling your... remote control submarine.
I remember that, yes.
Is that a hobby that you've had for long?
No, I just nicked it, actually.
Did you?
Yes.
But surely when you're using a remote control submarine, by the whole nature of the thing, the submarine's underwater and therefore you can't actually see it.
Hang on, agent.
Yes?
Cross
your legs.
Cross my legs, sorry.
To apologise for you. And do you not find that hobby a little bit pointless?
What hobby?
Your submarine hobby.
I've forgotten all about that. It was just a phase.
But also, you were seen suspiciously coming out the bushes and doing up your flies.
Yes, I'd just be for a piss. The call of nature.
We'll have to bleep that later.
No, you won't.
This is a live programme, so please keep the language down.
That's not bad language.
The other thing, of course, you were in the war. You were a great hero.
During the war, yeah.
And you escaped from Stalag 13. 45 years later, you turned up at Epsom Coaches Body Shop. Having not eaten all your sandwiches.
I still got the same sandwich, yes. Cheese and onion.
That was an incredible
sandwich.
Incredible feat, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, you worked with Charles Bronson in that film.
Yeah, I left him, actually, but he just couldn't keep up.
I know. And but I just think over the years you've been a complete idiot. Would you agree with that?
Totally, yes.
Are you a buffoon?
Totally, yes. Okay. Yes, I agree with that.
One of the other things I'd like to talk to you about is your appearance today.
Yes, now, stunning. That's the word you're going to use.
You appear to have changed sex.
I appear to have, yeah.
So are you now Simone?
I can be.
I can be anything you want. I mean,
you are on national television, Simone.
Words right out of my mouth.
You are on national television, Simone.
Yes.
Would you like to explain to the 10 million viewers at home, because I'm very popular, why you have appeared in women's clothes? And you look very fetching, I have to say.
Yes, that's not the word I would use, but...
Can you tell me about this transition to female?
I can't tell you a lot, actually. It just sort of happened.
What, you mean you got up in the morning
and they're like, yes.
Really? Have you been having hormone replacement therapy?
No, they're balloons, look.
See. So have you anything to add that now you've published your autobiography, how many copies do you expect to sell?
Well, at least half a dozen. Ish, right. Ish.
And you're going to be at Waterstones, I understand, in Oxford Street this week signing.
Yeah, yeah.
Are you going to go as Simone or Simmons?
That's yet to be decided.
Right.
By my agent.
Okay. How is your agent?
She's
seen you through a lot, hasn't she?
Feels white looking in.
Do apologise to the audience.
Sorry.
Simmons is not very well mentally.
And you have to,
and as it's Mental Health Week, we thought we'd bring him on. Yeah. He is no longer going to be starring in films. He's too old. We don't know whether he's male or female. He seems to have a bit of a personality complex. And all he can say is, yes, Gov. So I'm going to finish tonight and we'd like to thank you very much.
Yes,
for coming in to see us.
Oh,
and
okay.
Everyone give him a big round of applause for Simmons. After 37 years of being managing director of this business, I've decided I might as well join them. Love, hate. And so we come sadly to the end of this story, where Terry, Simmo, Simmons, Simone has finally passed away. And as we take him to his final resting place with great dignity, he ends as he started, signalling his intentions on a skip. Goodbye, Simone.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled and every highway and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets I've had a few, but then again too few to mention. I did what I had to do, saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step, a along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was dark, had my fill, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not. Yes, it was mine.